here getting set for kickoff of the 2019 season.
And you can pick up today's game program featuring team rosters and everything you need to know about today's game. You can purchase your game program at any of the ticket booths around Wayne Field for $1.
Test, test, test. Thank you. Hello and welcome to Bertagna Class of 1985 Stadium, Frank Bailey Field in Schenectady, New York, for today's 2019 season opener for the Union College football team as they take on the visitors from Westfield State University. Andrew Santillo here in the broadcast booth at Frank Bailey Field on a perfect early September afternoon, and we're ready to get things kicked off the 2019 season for the Union College Dutchmen. No one out on the field just yet, but we're about 10 minutes from kickoff. Union trying to have a positive 2019 season, certainly a terrific 2018 year that finished 7-2. The Dutchmen led by fourth-year head coach Jeff Behrman, and we'll hear from Coach Behrman in the pregame just before we get ready to kick things off here in Schenectady. First meeting between these two programs, Union and Westfield State. Westfield State located just west of the city of Springfield in Massachusetts, about a little less than 100 miles southeast of Schenectady. The Owls made the trek west this morning, and they are here as these two programs will play for the first time this afternoon. Union, a lot to be excited about for the Dutchmen. Many returning starters on both sides of the football, including the offense, which averaged over 31 points per game in 2018. Talked to Coach Behrman leading up to the season, and he was more focused not so much on the statistics, but the growth that the team could make, especially junior quarterback William Bellamy, who will be starting his second season at quarterback. Last year threw for over 2,000 yards and 22 touchdowns, 226 yards per game for William from Lafayette, Louisiana. And Coach Behrman was encouraged by the fact that he said Bellamy has said the game has really slowed down for him in this his second year under center. But Coach Behrman said looking for a little bit more growth from William and also a little bit more consistency this season. As some of the coaches start to trickle out for Union, and we're just about 5 minutes or so from kickoff here at Frank Bailey Field at Bertagna Class of 1985 Stadium. The stadium receiving that naming last season. So Union's got a lot of skill position players back on offense, and they also have four returning starters on the offensive line. They'll start one freshman in Max Langsam, and then also two sophomores and two juniors who played extensively last season. So that should be a strength for this Union offense. And with Bellamy at quarterback and some weapons behind him, most notably Andre Ross Jr., captains making their way out for Union. Three captains this season. Senior receiver Griffin Beal, who is one of those weapons for quarterback William Bellamy, and then two defensive seniors in senior linebackers in Evan Galland and George Reed are your three captains for the Dutchmen this season. So captains are out for both teams. Union went 7-2 last season in 2018. Coach Behrman said basically wanted to look forward to this year. Didn't want to harp on any of the statistics on either side of the ball, an offense that averaged over 31 points per game, a defense that allowed just 13 points a game. Westfield State went 5-5 a year ago. Union picked fourth in a Liberty League that is very tight at the top of the standings, with RPI, Ithaca, Union, and Hobart at the top of the preseason poll. Westfield State picked to finish sixth in the MASCAC, the Massachusetts State Collegiate Athletic Conference.
Preparing for today's coin toss, Union captains number 13, Griffin Deal, number 32, Evan Gillen, number 95, George Reed. Westfield State captain, number 1, Evan Garvey, number 2, Jack Buckley, number 5, Olav Ellis, number 75, Chris Sabah.
Westfield State captains making their way from the far side. It's Jack Buckley, Ethan Garvey, Chris Saba, their all-conference offensive lineman. And I believe it's Elijah Ellis, the fourth captain. Union has won the coin toss and deferred to the second half. So Union will kick. Westfield State will get the football to start the 2019 season here at Frank Bailey Field. The Dutchmen are about to make their appearance here on the field for the 2019 season. You'll hear from Coach Behrman in just a minute, but he said a good week of practice. He liked the way his team was getting prepared for Westfield State. He said if his team can play good team football, and he expects some strong defense, he really is only concerned with scoring one more point than Westfield and getting the victory this afternoon. Not worried about, as I said, any of the statistics, which a lot of good statistics last year for Union, but the one thing that may have just slipped out of reach was that Liberty League title, and you know that's what the 2019 team is gunning for this season. Back-to-back seven-win campaigns, 7-4 2 years ago, 7-2 last season. So Westfield will get the football, Westfield State. We will step aside and you will hear from Union head coach Jeff Behrman as we get set to kick off the 2019 season. You are listening to Union College Football.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time to honor America, we ask you to please rise and remove your hats for the playing of our national anthem.
Back here getting set for kickoff the 2019 season. Union College about to kick off against Westfield State. The 2019 season about to get underway. I'm pleased to be joined by Union head coach Jeff Behrman. Coach, your fourth season. Preseason's over. How good does it feel to get underway here and kick off the 2019 season?
Always excited to get a new season going. So, yeah, we're really excited. The guys are pumped up and ready to get going today.
The offense, we know, put up a lot of points last season. That was last year. You got a lot of skill guys back. But what does it mean, maybe most importantly, to have four guys back on the offensive line? You're starting one freshman up there.
It's most important. Without those guys, you know, it doesn't matter what the other guys do throughout the game. They got to, guys up front got to set the tone, got to get us going, and got to just make sure we're moving in the right direction. So those guys are extremely important.
Switching to the defensive side of the ball, statistically a good year last season. Again, that was last year. Just talk about maybe, how your defense is going to be tested against a team that's bringing back its quarterback in Westfield State and also was in the top 10 nationally in time of possession.
Yeah, you look at them. I mean, they're a veteran offense. You got four of their starting linemen are back, and then four are seniors. So they've been in the weight room at a college level for 4 years now. And, quarterback coming back, that's huge. There's a lot of experience there. So we're going to be tested. We don't know exactly who they are and what they do. So because it's a brand-new offensive coordinator. So, you're pretty much just going based on what you see in the first series and make the adjustments you need to make then.
Finally, we know you preach team football. You know, you're talking about just having one more point than the other team. But maybe what do you see as maybe some other keys to this afternoon's game?
Yeah, our kicking game. I mean, that's going to be a big part of it. It is a third of the game. So, our kicking game has to win. That's got to be our winning edge today and, be able to put us over the top.
Thanks, Coach. We'll be back for kickoff, the 2019 season, Union versus Westfield State. Thanks to Union head coach Jeff Behrman, starting his fourth season as Union College head coach, joined us in the pregame as we're ready to get underway. Coach Behrman, 17-13 all time here in Schenectady at Union. Kickoff left to right. Hauled in at the 15. We're underway the 2019 season. And being tossed down was Ethan Garvey, senior return man. Big time tackle there for the Dutchman defense as flying down there was a host of Union.
At the 27-yard line, first and 10 from the 27, that was a 12-yard run.
Special teamers. So ready to get underway here. First offensive possession or play of the 2019 season. First and 10 for quarterback Jake Cassidy. Cassidy fakes the handoff, and he is wrapped up by Vincent DiCaterino. Well, head coach Union head coach Jeff Behrman said he wanted to see this defense play. There's a lot of missing parts to graduation. Bobby Law up front, Jack Riley, Tucker Newman. But if that's any indication, this defense could be in for a heck of a year. They only allowed 13 points a game last season. That was DiCaterino on the tackle for loss. This one rolling to his left and the pass off of the hands of junior tight end Ethan Hallett. And it's just like that. It's third and looks about 16 from the Owls 21. Westfield State out of the Mascot, coached by sixth-year head man Pete Kowalski, who was the assistant coach and defensive coordinator for 18 years prior to being elevated to head coach. So he's been at Westfield State for three decades. This is an offense that was top 10 nationally in time of possession a year ago. They hand it off, big gain, and being knocked down. Christopher Belcito was knocked off his feet by sophomore Austin St. Pierre, and that will bring up fourth and long and a punt.
Austin St. Pierre.
So three and out, the Dutchman defense. We didn't even get to introduce you to them. Big hits from DiCaterino and the sophomore defensive back Austin St. Pierre, and also an incomplete pass. And it's fourth down, and that will bring out the punter, Cody Cleveland. Return men back for the Dutchman standing at the 35. They're looking right into the sun that's kind of facing north here. Midday. Kick pushes Kevin Raybacks back and a whistle there. I think they maybe thought he called a fair catch. And I think immediately the referee knew he made the wrong call. That's freshman Kevin Raybacks from Westport, Connecticut.
I don't know what they're going to do there. I don't think I've ever seen that happen. He went back. The punt was a good one from Cleveland. Raybacks went back. He had a lot of room to run, and they blew it dead. So I'm not sure. Coach Behrman down on the field trying to talk it over with the referees. I think they're going to redo this. They're going to have Westfield re-kick this. So Westfield's going to re-kick this. And that was a heck of a kick from the senior Cody Cleveland from Northampton, Massachusetts. Much of this Westfield State roster is from the state of Massachusetts. There's a handful of players from outside of the Bay State. So Cleveland back out. That was just a dress rehearsal here. First game, we're trying to iron out the kinks. So are the referees down there on the field.
Cody Cleveland, the punt. Take two.
Justin Fea and Kevin Raybacks still standing where they were for the first punt at the 35, although that first punt drove Raybacks all the way back close to the 20, actually. Westfield State snapping it from the 30, and Cleveland is standing at the 16-yard line ready to receive the snap. This one a little bit shorter. It's going to be Fea from the 34. Flag flies in. Fea, the junior from Marblehead, Massachusetts, taken down at the 39, close to the 40, but we'll see what the flag is here. Flag came out while the ball was in the air. So after all that, this penalty is going to push Union back, and it's kind of going to be almost where they were to begin this thing. We're going to be holding, and it's going to push the Dutchman back to the 24-yard line, and that's where Union will start its first offensive possession of the 2019 season, led by junior quarterback William Bellamy. 6 foot, 200 pounds from Lafayette, Louisiana. Last year, 63% completion, 226 passing yards per game, 22 touchdowns against 7 interceptions. Bellamy starts with 3 receivers and I.K. Irabor in the backfield. Fakes the handoff, finds Beal complete on the sideline. He tiptoes his way up to the 40, where he's taken out of bounds by George Cole, senior linebacker for the Owls. Union looks like they're not going to huddle and move quickly here. This is going to be a test for this Westfield State offense, or defense rather, that is very inexperienced coming into this season. Here's Irabor. He goes up the middle, gets about 3 before he's pushed back and held up. Get out to the 45, I.K. Irabor, the sophomore from Braintree, Massachusetts, who ended last season with 3 straight 100-yard rushing games and had 798 rushing yards in his freshman season. Bellamy's going to go up top for Ross. Touchdown, Union! Bellamy's first pass right on the mark. 55 yards to Andre Ross Jr. And Bellamy and Ross Jr. pick up where they left off last season, as the sophomore Ross Jr. had 13 receiving touchdowns last year, and he left the defensive back in his dust as he caught that one and glided into the end zone for a touchdown. 55-yard touchdown pass from Bellamy to Ross Jr. Extra point up, and it is good from Marcos Rodriguez. And it is 7-0 Union.
Marcos Rodriguez is good. With 12:28. remaining in the first quarter. Your score, Union 7, Westfield State 0.
So Union, a quick strike offense. They average 31 points per game. Of course, Coach Behrman said, you know, that I don't, you know, it's that doesn't matter how many points we averaged last season. But the high-octane Union offense picks up where it left off last season as William Bellamy connects with Andre Ross Jr., 55 yards for the touchdown. Union fans, visit Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady, open for lunch and dinner. Before or after Union games, it's the place to watch college football and hockey with friends and family. That's Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub, a proud supporter of Union College football. 12:28 to go here in the opening quarter. It's 7-0 Union. Ball bounces at the 20. It's picked up there by Todd Holloway Jr., and he goes out over the 25 to the 26 or 27-yard line, and that's where Westfield will take over. We'll take a look at that Union defense, three and out, the first possession. Up front.
At the 27-yard line, first and 10 for the Owls.
Up front to start was Vincent DiCaterino, Dan Gioso, and Tim Guiney. Out there right now, over the nose, Milo Baker-Durant, a sophomore from Needham, Massachusetts. Linebackers to start, two co-captains, George Reed and Evan Gillen. Cass Knox and Colin Lama. Linebacking unit was so strong last season. Running to the left side here, and a good pickup for the Owls on first down. That's Belcedo. Gets out to the 35. 8-yard pickup. It'll be second and short. In the secondary for Union, the corners are Paul Chambers. The starting corners were Paul Chambers and Travis Denby. Brandon Skadlock out there now at that far corner position. And the starting safeties, Joe Vanderhoof and Austin St. Pierre, your Union College defense. Snap to Cassidy, hands it off, trying to get to the first down line, and I don't think Belcedo did it. It'll be third down and short. Westfield State also trying to replace a talented running back, Trayvon Holder, who had back-to-back 1,000-yard, back-to-back 1,100-yard rushing seasons and rushed for over 3,400 yards in his career and 37 touchdowns. He has graduated. And Coach Kowalski said it will be a running back by committee, at least to start the 2019 season. Third and short, handoff Belcedo, and he's not going to get there. Wrapped up by George Reed, the senior from Towson, Maryland. And it'll be fourth down and two, and again, Union with a three and out here against the Westfield State offense. This is offense that averaged 23 points per game last season and over 336 yards of offense. Of course, they graduated the talented running back, Trayvon Holder, but Union putting some pressure on at least early in this first quarter. They've already had a couple tackle for losses and then two runs for no gain on that possession. Punt, a high hanger, pushes Faya back. It takes a big hop and goes into the end zone. Luckily for Union, the Dutchman will have it first and 10 after the touchback. Union leading 7-0 here with 10:14 to go in the first quarter. Dutchman fans, Brown Coach is the official charter company and a proud supporter of Union College Athletics. Call Brown Coach or Brown Travel for all of your charter and travel needs. Well, Coach Behrman couldn't have wanted a better start. His defense has gone three and out twice, and his offense has put up a touchdown, and they head back out onto the field. This talented Union offense. Bellamy takes the snap. Irabor running right. Breaking away from a shoestring tackle, he leaps out near a first down. It looks like he's going to be a yard short. I.K. Irabor, good blocking from that offensive line up front. Again, two sophomores two juniors and a freshman start for the Dutchman. Erebor shedding tacklers out over the 35. And I guess the ball may have come out, but I think the ref saying he was down. And it is a first down. Dutchman, the Westfield State sideline, was signaling it was their football. So first down, Union. Offensive lineman up front as we try to get these starters in, but Union moving in a hurry. We'll give them to you after this play. Three receivers. Bellamy looks to the sideline. Erebor to his left. Little out route, complete to Beal at midfield. Makes a move, gets inside, and goes down the sideline for a first down into Westfield State territory.
Number 46, Dave White. Number 37, Joseph Dumoulin.
Pickup of 26 down to the 36 of Westfield State. And it's a first down for the Dutchmen. Up front, Tim Driscoll, Chris Kachadurian, Ryan Aritz, Teddy Hood, and Max Langsam. Again, two juniors, two sophomores, and a freshman, but four of those guys, all but Max Langham, the freshman, started a year ago, or at least at the end of last year. Here's Erebor running right. He's got a lot of room, cuts back to the middle, makes a move, and he is good to go, but he trips himself up at the 10. The only person who could stop I.K. Erebor was himself as he lost his footing and goes down at the 10-yard line.
A gain of 26 on the play.
Pickup of 26. Union hurries to the line. Three receivers to the near side. Little bubble screen. Here's Ross Jr. Touchdown, Union! As Ross Jr., two possessions, two touchdowns. William Bellamy connects with Andre Ross Jr. For a 10-yard touchdown toss, it's 13-0 Union.
A 10-yard play.
Rodriguez out for the extra point. It is up, and it's good. With 8:23 remaining in the opening quarter, it's Union 14, Westfield State 0. On a beautiful afternoon for football here in Schenectady, New York at Frank Bailey Field. Beautiful for Dutchman fans so far. Union fans, be sure to stop by the Center Street Pub located at 308 Union Street in Schenectady, featuring TVs to watch all of your favorite teams, great food, and live entertainment. Center Street is a proud partner of Union College Football and Union College Athletics. That's the Center Street Pub located in downtown Schenectady. Well, the Dutchmen are leading 14-0, and two possessions, two touchdown passes for Bellamy to Ross Jr. Ross Jr. had at least one touchdown in every game last year except the Ithaca game, and that was a game that the Union didn't score in. He's got two already in the first quarter here. Kick caught in on the far side, going up the sideline for the Owls. I believe that was Garvey out over the 25, and that's where Westfield State.
First and 10.
Will start its third possession. Well, so far a lot to like. Union's defense has been impressive. They've gotten penetration up front. Westfield State was in the top 10 in the nation last year in time of possession, and now a pre-snap penalty here as the flags fly. Delay of game. Certainly not what you want on the first play of the possession. You come back, move it to the 21, it'll be first down and 15. And Westfield State, as I was just saying, last year, top 10 in the nation in time of possession. Actually, we're eighth in that statistic last year. Again, they had a 1,100-yard rusher in Trayvon Holder. Pass over the hands of Garvey, looking for the 5'7" native of Dalton, Massachusetts, who had 18 receptions last year. This is an offense that is more comfortable running the ball. Coach Kowalski said he wanted to be more of a run-style offense. Unfortunately for the Owls, they trail by 14 here early and might need Jake Cassidy to use a little bit more of his arm. Handoff up the middle. Nowhere to go there. Colin Lama in from the linebacker spot. May have lost a yard, actually. Back to the 20 was Jermaine Everett Welcome.
Jermaine Everett Welcome on the play. Tackle on the play.
So it'll be third and 16 facing Westfield State. About halfway through this first quarter, it's 14-0 Union. Cassidy in the shotgun, as he has been throughout this first quarter, has three receivers, fakes the handoff, rolling to his right, has nothing, now tries to get rid of it for his tight end, Adam Cahill, but he couldn't handle it on the sideline, and it will be fourth down. Well, so far, Rick Flanders' defense, which was impressive last year, has seen 9 plays and 3 3 and outs, has not allowed a first down to Westfield State. So for the third time, Cody Cleveland comes back out to punt.
Cody Cleveland to punt.
He only punted 39 times last year. He's already punted 3 times in the first half of this first quarter. Union return man standing at the 40. High hanger. Caught by, this is Faya. He made a nice move around the first line of defense and then is tackled at the Westfield State 49. And that's where Union will start its third drive of this first quarter. 2 for 2 so far. They're hoping for another. First down and 10, and so far this Union offense has been too much to handle for this Westfield State defense. Coach Kowalski said he thought his defense would be good eventually in this season. He just thought maybe they might take some lumps early because of the inexperience. Bellamy, pass complete, and a nice tackle on that far side by Jack Buckley. Pass was complete to Faya. He got back to the line of scrimmage. So it's second down and 10, a nice play from Buckley. Union with keeping that three wide receiver personnel all to the near side, Beal, Ross Jr., and Faya. Here's Irabor. He's got a big hole up the middle and a first down for IK Irabor. That offensive line is having its way, pushing this Westfield State defensive line, which starts a lot of freshmen, 3 or 4 freshmen on this Owls defense. Up front, they've got Richard Ross, Jake Mullins, Peter Spinelli, Dejon Cummings. Linebackers are Dave White, Rayshon Settles, and George Cole. And in the secondary, Danny Ledoux, Joseph Dumoulin, Elijah Ellis, and Jack Buckley. A young defensive unit for the Owls. Irabor spinning out of a tackle, still on his feet, being pushed back at the 30, but another big pickup on first down as Irabor goes for 8 on first down, and he's going to head to the sideline.
A gain of 8 on the play.
As the referee trying to get the play clock
at the 30-yard line.
coordinated here as he now rewinds the game clock. 5:45 to go in the opening quarter. Union 14, Westfield State nothing. Joe Ferreira has checked in, the sophomore from Rocky Hill, Connecticut. They'll give him a carry. And not as much room, although they didn't take him down. They blew the whistle.
Joseph Ferreira.
It'll be third down and two. Ferreira got back to the line of scrimmage. Only 19 carries last year for Ferreira, sophomore from Rocky Hill, Connecticut. Union quick to the line, third and short. Ferreira again. Met and pushed back, and he's going to be short of the first down. A good play by Richard Ross, freshman from Ewing, New Jersey. It's going to be fourth down, and Union's got the offense on the field. They're going to try and run quick here. Bellamy in the pistol. Gives to Ferreira. Flags fly. Ferreira's got the first down. But based on the timing of those flags, I would think it is, well, maybe not. Thought it was going to be a procedure call on the Dutchman. It looked like the indication actually was it was going to go against Westfield State. Referees coming together here, trying to straighten this one out. If it stands, it would be a first down after Ferreira's third straight run up the middle. So it was a offsides on Westfield State. Union declines the penalty, and they'll take the Ferreira run down to the 25. It'll be first and 10, Dutchman.
First
and 10 from the 25. Snap to Bellamy, gives to Ferreira again. Big hole up the middle, and he's got another first down. Close to the 10-yard line. Ferreira going right up the middle behind junior center Ryan Aritz and right guard Teddy Hood.
That play results in a first down for the Dutchman.
Union pushing its way down the field on its third drive. First and 10 from the 11. Not sure why the clock stopped. Here's Erebor going to the left side, and he is pushed out of bounds by
run.
Buckley and a couple of other Westfield State defenders.
Second down coming up, the ball be placed at about the 7-yard line. A gain of 4 on the play, second down from the 7.
Erebor picked up 4. They've got it spotted at the 7 at the far hash mark. Union looking to tack on another touchdown here. The Union offense has been unstoppable in this first quarter. Bellamy gives to Erebor. I.K. Erebor still on his feet inside
the
5. Really churning his way up the middle. And even though a host of Westfield State defenders were there,
Third down. They
couldn't stop Erebor until finally they took him down, but not after 3 or 4 yards. It'll be third down and looks like 2 from the 3. Bellamy, snap, rolling right, looking to the back of the end zone. He's got his man. Touchdown, Griffin Beal. Well, Griffin Beal, who we sat down with earlier this week, and you'll hear an interview with him at halftime, makes his first touchdown reception of his senior season. The senior co-captain had 5 touchdowns a year ago, and that is his 12th career touchdown reception for the senior from Reading, Massachusetts. Kick is up and it is good. 3:17 to go here in the first quarter. It's been all Union, 21-0 Dutchman. You're listening to Union College Football. Union fans, Union Athletics would like to thank Nico's Pizzeria and Rooftop Tavern, located on State Street in downtown Schenectady. Nico's serves lunch, dinner, and late-night food in daily specials. Call for delivery. That's Nico's Pizzeria and Rooftop Tavern, located downtown Schenectady. Proud supporter of Union College and Union College football. Union here, 3:17 to go in the first quarter. Union's pretty much playing a perfect game as Will Halpin will kick. Puts his right foot into it. Caught inside the 10 by Holloway Jr. Burst of speed for Todd Holloway out to the 26, and that's where Westfield will take over. Well, I thought Union might have the advantage here. They've got a host of skill players back from a high-octane offense. Coach Behrman was anxious to see how his defense would play, and the defense has been lights out here in this first quarter against a Westfield State offense that was pretty successful a year ago. Again, we said they averaged 23 points a game and went 5-5, and Union is can't be stopped on defense. Handoff and stuffed in the background and the backfield is Everett Welcome. A flag comes in late.
There is a penalty marker on the field.
Everett Welcome tossed for a loss back at the 21 by Colin Lama. Lama Jr. from Stoughton, Massachusetts. Face mask on Westfield State. Co-captain George Reed, we could hear him up here saying, we want 1st and 20 or 2nd and 12. Face mask called on the senior tight end Adam Cahill. Declined, so it looks like he said 2nd and 12, George Reed said. It looks more like 2nd and 16.
Second down.
As Westfield State's back to the 21-yard line. Here's Cassidy rolling to his left. Puts it up, and it's incomplete. And a flag comes in late after it was over the hands of Ethan Garvey.
For number one, Evan Garvey.
They said 41. I thought the pass was over the hands of Evan Garvey, and then he got pushed. I thought that's where the call was, but I don't think that was the number they called. Either way, it moves the Owls out to the 36 and gives them a first down. Cassidy in the shotgun, four receivers, three the near side. Handoff Everett Welcome, and he's got nowhere to go. This Union defensive line is up to the task so far. A 3-4 defensive line. Lama and DiCaterino. DiCaterino, who is had a heck of a 2017 and then backed it up with a 2018 where he had 6.5 tackles for loss and 5 sacks. Kind of burst onto the scene 2 years ago. Union leading 21-0 here, 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Cassidy fakes the handoff. He's running out of time. Tries to get away, still on his feet. And he is going to be taken down finally by a Union gang tackle. Cassidy spun out of it. He's a little bit of a runner himself. Ran for 456 yards last year as the junior quarterback. He did his best to keep that play alive and ended up getting taken down back at the 35. So it'll be second down and 11 for the Owls. Still four receiver set. They may have to keep somebody else in to avoid this. Another sack. And this time it is up the middle. Jamar Edwards, the freshman from White Plains, New York. Sacks Cassidy back at the 25, and it'll be fourth down for Westfield State. Nice looking stunt from Jamar Edwards, who kind of faked going in and went looping around and came unabated to the quarterback and took him down. Union's got to have 3 or 4 sacks here in this first quarter. 30 seconds to go. They're going to get the football back. Return men standing at the 38. The punt from Cleveland. Fair catch called for and bobbled, and now it's back with Westfield State. So the first mistake comes very late in this first quarter as a fair catch was called for and Raybax had it hit him and it bounced right to the Westfield State defender.
First and 10.
So Westfield's going to get the ball at the Union 30, and this will be the first play inside Union territory. Comes with 21 seconds to go in this first quarter. So a break there for the Owls. We'll see if they can make Union pay after the fumble. First turnover in this game. Cassidy back out there. Low snap. Rolls right. Flag comes down. Cassidy takes off, and he's pushed out of bounds, tackled by Max Jakeway, I believe, over on that far sideline. Holding called on the center, Saul Cabrera. Westfield State has a veteran offensive line. However, not all of them have experience. 5 seniors up front, including Chris Saba, who is an all-conference guy, and their center, Saul Cabrera, who 2 years ago was an all-conference guy in the MASCAC, along with Kevin Joyce, Connor Gregoire, and Sean Green up front for the Owls. And that's the end of the first quarter. Good first quarter for the Dutchmen. Union 3 touchdowns. And the Dutchmen lead it 21-0 over Westfield State. The first quarter, you're listening to Union College Football from Frank Bailey Field here in Schenectady, New York at Bertagna Class of 1985 Stadium. Union fans, Trusco Bank is proud to be a leading community sponsor of Union College Football and Union College Athletics, offering residential mortgages, hometown checking, and friendly personal service. Trusco Bank has been serving our community since 1902. Trusco Bank, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College football. Well, after the turnover on the punt, Union's defense backed up. They had a negative play on that last play of the first quarter, so Westfield State has it. Excuse me, there was a hold, which pushed Westfield State back to the 40, Union's 40. It's first down and 20 for Jake Cassidy and the Owls offense.
First and 20 from the 40.
See if Westfield makes any adjustments. They've had four receivers. Now they have three receivers to start this second quarter, bring another guy in to try and give Cassidy some more time against this Union defensive line, which has been in the backfield. Here's Everett Welcome, the sophomore from Windsor, Connecticut. Big guy, 6 foot 255. Picks his way for 2 yards to the 38. Taken down by junior Dan Gioso, who had a heck of a sophomore campaign, 43 tackles last year, coming right up the middle, which is where he'll be this season after the graduation of Bobby Law. He's going to have to step up in that nose position. Cassidy shotgun snap, pass complete on the far hash mark, and a short gain to Cam Gallagher. Gallagher got tackled at the 33, so it'll be third and short for Westfield State. Opening minute of the second quarter, it's 21-0 Union.
From the 33. Faking
the handoff, now dumping it off as Cassidy to his tight end, and they're going to be short of the line to gain, although
number 88.
It's going to bring up fourth down at the 31 after the hold pushed him back. This will be fourth down and 11. Cassidy just had to get rid of it there as he was in being pursued again.
It will be fourth and 11.
Fourth and 11. Westfield State will keep its offense out on the field, kind of in that no man's land here, as that would be a very long field goal attempt. So Coach Kowalski keeps the offense on the field. Cassidy, here's some time. Now we'll roll out, and a flag comes in. Cassidy's trying to make his way to the sideline. He's going to be well short of the first down.
Cassidy.
So that will be a turnover on downs, and Westfield State was flagged, although Union should decline this, and they'll take over the football at, it's being marked at the 27. DiCaterino came around the end and then ended up getting tackled by left tackle Kevin Joyce. So it'll be first and 10 Union at the Dutchman 27.
At the 27-yard line. First and 10 for the Dutchman.
So Bellamy and the offense back out for Union. 21-0 lead, 12:56 to go before halftime. Bellamy fakes the handoff, complete to Ross Jr. He's got a first down, and he's held up by a handful of Westfield defenders, including Elijah Ellis.
Tackled on the play, number 5, Elijah Ellis. Number 23, Rashawn Settles.
And Rashawn Settles.
And a first down for the Dutchman. A gain of 16 on the play.
Bellamy takes the snap, handoff to Erebor. He cuts in, now gets to the near sideline. He's going to be taken down by Ellis, but a big pickup for Erebor, who goes inside the 40, first down, and again, following this offensive line, which opened up a gigantic hole for IK Erebor. Union offense rolling once again here early in the second quarter as they have made their way into Westfield territory at the 37. Bellamy, three receivers, two to the far side. Fakes the handoff, little bubble screen for Beal. Gets a couple of blocks downfield, a flag comes in. Beal has a first down, and he's hit late, it looked like, as he was being held up. Westfield again saying they have the ball. I think this is going to be holding downfield on one of the Union receivers. Actually, it might have been on the tight end, Andrew Shaheen. Some good blocking downfield, although I guess it was a little too good. Nope, they're going to call it on Faya. Because the hold took place downfield, it's only going to move Union back a couple of yards. It will replay first down. Move back to the 41, so it'll be first and 14 for Union. Bellamy looking up top. He's got Ross Jr. wide open. Touchdown, Andre Ross Jr. And the hat trick here in the first half as Ross Jr. got behind the defense. And Bellamy connects 41 yards for the touchdown. Well, if there was any thoughts of Andre Ross Jr. being a freshman flash in the pan, think again, three touchdowns here in the first half of the season opener. And he's already got 16 career touchdowns in just 10 games. Extra point up and good from Rodriguez, and with 11:22 to go before halftime, it's Union 28, Westfield State nothing. Union fans, Wolf's Beer Garden in Schenectady offers the best German local and craft brews. Join Wolf's for lunch, dinner, and weekend brunch, plus every Wednesday for Union Night. It's your official tailgating and away game watch party for Union football, plus men's and women's hockey. Go Union, Wolf's Beer Garden in Schenectady. Proud supporter of Union College Athletics and Union College football. Dutchman rolling here, 28-0. Still early in the second quarter, but Union has three passing touchdowns from William Bellamy to Andre Ross Jr. and one rushing touchdown for IK Erebor. Here comes Garvey from the 10. Nice little return for Evan Garvey out close to the 30. Well, if anybody's played better than Union's offense, it may be Union's defense. They had three and outs to start the game. Then after a fumble on a punt, they shut down the Westfield State offense. The Owls have had trouble getting anything going. It's first and 10 at the 29 to start for Westfield State. And just like that, an interception. It's picked off by Mark Zazzaro. So the pass sailed high. And Mark Zazzaro, the junior from Wethersfield, Connecticut, his first career interception. And Union's offense is set up to cash in as Zazzaro was sitting back in the secondary, and he had an easy interception going the other way. First interception of the season from Cassidy, who had seven last year. Westfield State, unfortunately, kind of coming out of their run-first offense because they trail by a few touchdowns. So Dutchman have it first and 10 at the Westfield State 30. Erebor running left. Trying to spin away. A flag flies in from the secondary. And the indication it's going to be a hold on Union. Union's had a couple of holding calls, but by and by, the offensive line has done a terrific job blocking and giving I.K. Erebor and Joe Ferreira some room to run. So far, Bellamy has yet to throw an incompletion. 9 of 9 for 179 yards and 4 touchdowns. I think I said Erebor had a touchdown. Bellamy's actually thrown 4 touchdowns, 3 to Ross Jr. and then the 1 to Beal. Ross Jr. has 4 receptions for 125 yards and 3 touchdowns. And Erebor has 9 carries for 90 yards. Pretty much Union is doing anything it wants offensively in this first half. Again, stay with us at halftime. We have an interview with senior co-captain receiver Griffin Beal, who caught a touchdown in this first half. One of 3 captains this season, along with senior linebackers Evan Galland and George Reed. So first and 20 for the Dutchman. Handoff, Erebor starting left, spins away. Tried another spin move, and he's tossed out of bounds by Elijah Ellis. Inside the 35, so Erebor got most of the penalty back. It'll be 2nd and 13 from the 33-yard line. Well, Union no doubt has come to play here in this first half. The offense doing pretty much anything it wants here early against Westfield State. Bellamy the snap. Got some pressure but got rid of it quickly. The far side, first completion for Will Sermon. Sermon, the junior from Destrehan, Louisiana, Holy Cross transfer. His first reception of his Union career. And picked up a short gain. It'll be 3rd and 8 for the Dutchmen, who are looking to the sideline for the call. 3 receivers out there. Herman, Shresha, and Sermon. Herman and Sermon. Bellamy looking for a little screen over the middle. Sermon got away from a defender trying to get to that first down marker, and he did so. Will Sermon was cutting across the middle. Did a good job to get away from a defender and get the first down to the 20, which is exactly where Union needed to get to. So first down Union with 9:05 to go here in the first half. Dutchman continue to roll here. And Bellamy has still yet to throw an incompletion. He's 11 of 11. Handoff coming to I.K. Erebor, running left. Running through defenders. He's got another first down. Well, he got back up and went into the end zone, but they say he's down at the 9-yard line. It'll be first and goal for the Dutchman.
First and goal from the 9. A gain of 11 on the play.
11-yard pickup for Erebor. As some clouds have come in here, it was a pretty perfect day. Temperature in the mid-70s. In early September, Bellamy takes the snap. Ferreira running right. got tripped up from behind. Another flag comes in. And Ferreira got inside the five, but we'll see what the call is. And he is down on the field. Actually, it's not Ferreira down on the field. He's back in the huddle. Not sure who it is, but it's... So Ferreira did get tripped because that was the penalty. And it's going to move the football inside the five and be first and goal for Union. Like that's 82 sophomore Angelo DeSalvo, who is back up to his feet and limping off the field under his own power. Union's got a first and goal after the tripping call. Bellamy has one receiver and he's got Ferreira in the backfield. It's Ferreira into the end zone for a touchdown. 2-yard touchdown for Joseph Ferreira. And Union's up 34-0 with 7:51 to go in this first half. For Ferreira, that's his first career touchdown. The sophomore from Rocky Hill, Connecticut. And it's the fifth touchdown of this first half for the Dutchman. Been all Union in this first half of this first game, the season opener. Rodriguez tacks on the extra point, and it's 35-0 Union. Well, I'm not sure anybody saw this coming. I think we, you know, at least on paper, Union was the favorite in this game. But for Union to come out on full, both sides of the football on full cylinder here, five touchdowns in this first half and not allowing Westfield State's only plays they've run in Union's end became because of a turnover on a punt, and the defense quickly shut down Westfield State's offense.
Will happen to kick off.
So three in this first half for Ross Jr., one for Beal, four passing touchdowns for Bellamy, and one rushing touchdown for Joseph Ferreira. Kickoff hauled in by Evan Garvey at the 15. Garvey makes a man miss, gets into the middle of the field and squirts up near the 35, where it'll be first down and 10 Westfield State. Well, they'll mark him at the 33. First down and 10 for the Owls. .743 to go here in this second quarter. It's been all Union, 35-0. Good guys. Snap to Cassidy. Screen pass kind of set up on that far side. And getting out near the first down is Shaquille Ajayi. Pickup of nine. That'll be second down and short for the Owls at their own 41. Cassidy, handoff. It was Adjay again. Shaquille Adjay. 5'10" senior from Worcester, Mass. So third and a yard here from Westfield's 42. Let's see if the Union defense can once again get off the field. It's been pretty much a flawless half for the Dutchman defense. Snap for Cassidy, fakes the handoff, going to keep it himself. He's got the first down, and he's into Union territory where he's taken down.
That play results in a first down for the Owls.
Tackle was made by sophomore cornerback Matt Sermonario.
Ball plays.
Sophomore from Fairfield, Connecticut. First down and 10 for Westfield State at the Union 46. Cassidy takes the snap, gives to Adjay, and Adjay is toppled down by
number 29, Shaquille Adjay on the play, tackle on the play. Number 37, Harrison Parsons.
Harrison Parsons in on the tackle. Senior from Hopkinton, Mass. Second and 9 from the 45 for the Owls. Cassidy looking to the near side. Garvey makes the catch. Flag comes out. And it's a short 5-yard pass from Cassidy to Garvey, but there's a flag down, and I think this is going to be on Westfield State. Block in the back on that little bubble wide receiver screen, and it's going to push Westfield State back 10 yards. Remains second down. Should be, I think, at the 45 of Westfield State. So it's going to be second and 19 after the 10-yard penalty. This run bottled up, and Union pushing him back. Cam Adams, sophomore linebacker from Saratoga Springs, makes the stop. No gain. It'll be third and 19. That was Jermaine Everett. Welcome. Third and long here. Union's going to drop. Only rushes four. Pass off of the hands of Scadlock. Brandon Scadlock, junior cornerback, had it go through his hands. It'll be fourth down. Scadlock, the junior from Beechwood, Ohio, comes to the sideline. He thinks he should have had that one. It'll bring up a punt here for Cody Cleveland back out there. Fourth punt of the first half. Boots it away. Nice punt. Raybax calls for the fair catch, and he'll make it at the 10. And that's where Union will have the football, with 4:15 to go before halftime. Again, stick with us at halftime as we'll have an interview with Union senior receiver co-captain Griffin Beal. Union fans, have an online store for all of your shopping needs. Visit unionathleticsgear.com for replica jerseys, Union gear, and gifts for that Dutchman fan in your life. Visit unionathleticsgear.com That's unionathleticsgear.com. And not too far away from the holidays, check it out, unionathleticsgear.com, for all of your Union gear. First down completion on the near sideline to sophomore receiver Robbie Herman from Wilton, Connecticut. His first reception of the season. Out to the 21. 11-yard pickup. Good for a first down. And see what Union does here, leading 35-0, under 4 minutes to go, as there's a new quarterback in for the Dutchman. Handoff for number 23 coming across, Griff Wallner, sophomore from nearby Half Moon, New York, Shenandoah High graduate. And now into the game is quarterback John Germanario.
Second down.
Germanario from nearby Wynantskill, Troy High graduate. Takes the snap, throws it to the near side. He's got his man. That's Herman again. And he's got a first down out over the 35. The Union quarterbacks, Bellamy and Germanario, I don't believe there's been a completion, incompletion in this first half. There hasn't been. Bellamy was 11 of 11 for 192 and four touchdowns. Germanario's going to tuck this. Here, he can make some moves, and he goes into Westfield State territory. Big pickup for Germanario. Pickup of 18 for John Germanario. Well, Germanario certainly can hold his own here at quarterback. He helped lead Troy High to a state title in his days as a Flying Horse. Short handoff there to Wallner. So Union already sprinkling in a few of the backups here before halftime. I don't think, again, anyone saw that coming. Wallner loses a yard. So you got two Section 2 guys in the backfield there in Germanario and Griff Wallner. Shenandoah High and Troy High. Germanario looking to the sideline. Takes the snap. Nice pass, complete. On the near side, it's was caught by Finn Duran. And now a timeout, Westfield State. So Germanario to Finn Duran, that picked up 7 and brings up a third down and 4 for the Dutchman. Well, overcast skies have moved in here as we've played this first half, but certainly nothing to damper the mood here of the Union College fans, as the Dutchmen lead it 35-0 here in the first half. Good way to open the season at home, a season that has, I think, high expectations. Picked 4th in the Liberty League preseason, however, I think Union would tell you they, the players and coaches, expect to be vying for that Liberty League title in this 2019 season. Certainly bunched at the top with Ithaca, Hobart, and defending champion RPI. Caught by Duran, little slant, and he's got a first down. Westfield State's got a player down near the line of scrimmage. 92 senior Jake Mullins, slow to get up, but well, Mullins got to his feet. I think he's got to leave the field, though, because they blew it dead. So it's going to be fourth down for Union. I thought he had the first down, but they spotted him back at the 37. So it's going to be fourth and one. Union's going to keep its offense on the field. German Aereo in the pistol with Wallner behind him. Now he audibles, and Wallner will stand just to his right in the shotgun. Wallner, a counter, and he's got the first down inside the 35, and that'll keep this drive moving. With a minute to go here before halftime, have to wonder if Coach Behrman is going to take a shot at the end zone here with his team up by 35.
Again, four on the play. First and 10 from the 33.
Clock rolling, 45 seconds to go before halftime. German Aereo with Wallner to his right. Fakes the handoff, now he's going to scramble to his right. Nothing downfield, so he's going to get out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Short pickup for John German Aereo. Well, I tell you, most teams don't have a backup who is as accomplished as German Aereo. Again, helped Troy Hyde a state title when he was in high school. Only threw five passes last year. 2 for 5 for 15 yards as Bellamy took the majority of the snaps. But German Aereo seeing some action here in the first half. That certainly should bode well. Obviously, Union would like to get as many guys on the field as possible. German Aereo, the handoff to Wallner. Wallner trying to push up the middle. Offensive line gave him a little bit. Short pickup for Wallner, give him maybe 3 to the 27. And the clock's going to run out here. So Union's going to sit on this 35-0 lead as we go into the half. One half of play in the books here from Frank Bailey Field at Bertagna Class of 1985 Stadium. And at the half, it is Union 35 and Westfield State nothing. Couldn't have asked for much more in that first half if you're a Union fan. High-octane offense, 4 passing touchdowns for William Bellamy. And the defense pitches a shutout in the first half. So as we go to the locker room, it's Union 35, Westfield State nothing. Again, stay with us here. We'll have a look at some other scores around the league. And we'll have an interview with senior co-captain Griffin Beal, who had a receiving touchdown in that first half. We recorded this during the week, so he's actually not coming up here. But through the magic of radio and streaming, we will have that in TV, I guess you could say. Streaming, through the magic of streaming, we'll have that interview with you here at halftime with Griffin Beal. So we'll have a look at some statistics and some scores from out of the area. RPI had a lead very early in that game, which has got to be almost finished because they started at noon. But all Union in this first half, nothing but smiles on the home sideline here at Bailey Field. It's Union 35, Westfield State nothing. So we'll take a quick break, and then we'll be back with a look at some of the first half stats, and then we'll have an interview with senior co-captain Griffin Beal. You have been listening to Union College Football here on UnionCollegeAthletics.com. Back here, it's halftime at Frank Bailey Field at Bertagna-Class of 1985 Stadium. Union leading it 35-0 over Westfield State. A perfect, if you can call it that. I'm sure the coaches would have would not go that far, as no coach ever will say his team is playing perfect, especially in the first game. But boy, oh boy, about as perfect as you can play a first half, as Union scores 35 points. They lead 35-0. They did have one turnover, but the defense held Westfield State off of the scoreboard. No incompletions between two quarterbacks, as in that first half, Will Bellamy went 11 of 11 for 192 yards and four touchdowns. Andre Ross Jr., four catches for 192 yards and four touchdowns in his short Union career. He's averaged over 100 yards per game coming into this game. Well, that'll go up higher, 103 yards a game in his freshman season. 57 catches for 929 last year as a freshman. First half, four catches, 125 yards. I think I said 192 yards. That was what Bellamy had. Bellamy was of 11 of 11 for 192 yards and four touchdowns. John Germanario came in. He was 4 of 4 for 30 yards. So all in all, it adds up to 15 passes attempted, 15 completions for Union quarterbacks for 222 yards and four touchdowns. Andre Ross Jr. had four receptions for 125 yards and three touchdowns. Griffin Beal, who you'll hear from in just a minute, four catches for 54 yards and a touchdown, two catches apiece for Robbie Herman and Will Sermon. Ike Irabor, 11 carries for 108 yards, no touchdowns. Joseph Ferrara, six carries, 26 yards and a touchdown for Union. On the other side, Christopher Belcedo led Westfield State's rushers, three carries, 17 yards. Jake Cassidy, three completions, eight attempts, one interception, 15 yards passing. Three catches went to three different receivers, Gallagher, Hallett, and Adjay. Most work of the day for Westfield State went to Cody Cleveland in that first half. Five punts, averaged 44.8 yards a punt, had a long of 65 that bounced into the end zone for a touchback. Defensively leading the way for Union College, five tackles for Vinny DiCaterino, four apiece for Cam Adams and Colin Lama. Union had five tackles for loss in that first half, two sacks, one from Jamar Edwards, the freshman, and the other one from Vincent DiCaterino. Elijah Ellis, seven tackles to lead the way for the Owls. David White had six, and George Cole and Rayshon Settles, five apiece for Westfield State. So Union leads it 35-0 at the half. There's some sponsors that the Union College football team would like to thank for their support this season. That's Brown Coach, CDPHP, Center Street Pub, Courtyard by Marriott, the Mohawk Harbor, Courtyard by Marriott at the Mohawk Harbor, Curtis Lumber, Doubletree by Hilton, Trusco Bank, Dunkin' Donuts, Hampton Inn of Schenectady, the Katie O'Burns Irish Pub, Price Chopper and Market 32, Ortho New York, New Country Lexus of Latham, CEFQ, Northeastern Fine Jewelry, Douglas Alman Commercial, Homewood Suites, the Union Inn, and Wolf's Beer Garden, all sponsors of Union College football and Union College athletics. We will take one more quick break and be back with an interview with Senior Co-Captain Griffin Beal. You are listening to Union College football. back here. It's halftime at Frank Bailey Field. Union College leads it 35-0 over Westfield State. We had a chance to catch up with senior co-captain Griffin Beal this week after practice, and we've got an interview with Griffin, who had a receiving touchdown in that first half.
Back here on the Union College football broadcast, it's halftime of the season and home opener against Westfield State, and I'm proud to be joined by senior co-captain Griffin Beal. Griffin, thanks for stopping by and joining us here at halftime.
Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
Griffin, talk about goals maybe for this offense. Everybody saw the team put up 31 points per game last year in 2018. So there's a lot of expectations for this offense. A lot of guys are back. You're second leading receiver with 49 catches. Just talk about maybe some of the goals for the offensive unit coming back starting this year.
I think offensively, we got a lot of guys coming back, and I think last year we were just getting our feet wet. I mean, we got a lot of chemistry. We worked a lot over spring, over the summer. The wideouts working with the quarterbacks and bringing the freshmen along too, just getting the offense ready. And the line looks real good too, so we're looking to put up way more points than last year. Hopefully passing yards, rushing yards, everything increases too.
Just talk about the relationship that the offense kind of with a lot of those guys, key pieces back. I mean, a lot of weapons. IK, you had 49 catches last year, so there's a real relationship here that's been built, I think, over last year that you guys will be hoping to build on, I think, this season.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I know me, IK, and Andre and Will have a great relationship, and we got one of the best quarterbacks in Division III football, personally, I think. And I know the wide receivers agree with that. And I just got a cannon. So we're just excited to get after it this year and air the ball out and see what we can do.
Now, senior year, can you believe it? I mean, it's like you blinks and all of a sudden you're a senior. Just talk about maybe getting ready for this senior year, coming back to school, your last camp before getting ready for your last season of college football.
Yeah, it's crazy. Last week was my last preseason ever for football and any sport. So it's definitely crazy. I mean, yesterday it felt like I was a freshman, backup quarterback, not even playing wide out yet. So it's definitely crazy going into senior year. And I know me and the senior class, we're just ready to leave it all out there on the field and off the field. We're ready to have
captain your senior year. Just talk about maybe what that means, about what the guys think about your leadership and the coaches. What does that mean to you personally to be one of the three captains this season?
Personally, is one of my biggest achievements athletically. I've been playing football my whole life, basketball, baseball, all the sports, you name it. And we pick our captains voted on by the players. So to know the players trusted in me and saw me as a leader is definitely a big thing for me. And being a captain with Evan and George too along my side is it's really helpful. And we're just ready to lead this team.
Evan Gilland, George Reed, and Griffin Beal, who's joining me here, the three captains for the 2019 season. Griffin, we're just starting the 2019 season, but just, fast forward a bit here. Your final year of college. Just tell me, what are you maybe interested in doing and, your life after Union College?
Yeah, right now I'm an economics major and a political science minor, so I'm hopefully trying to get into the finance world, whether that be a job in Boston or New York City. I'm still looking now, and hopefully either live at home or move out. I'm open for whatever.
Football, you mentioned some other sports too that you played growing up. You mentioned also your other positions that you played here at Union. What about receiver? Do you enjoy? And what kind of about football? Obviously you've been playing since you've been a young kid. What about the game do you enjoy?
I just love the fast-paced motion of football. I like using my reactionary skills, and I just like being able to let loose on the field and have a good time with my friends. And I feel like football is a very team-oriented sport, and I really like that aspect of the game.
Now we're going to do some quick hitters here. Quick question, and we'll just do some quick answers back and forth here. How about favorite sports team? Being from the Boston area, I have to imagine it's one of those teams in Boston.
Yeah, City of Champions. I got to go with the New England Patriots. I've been loving them my whole life, but Boston Celtics definitely a close second.
So then this will lead to my favorite sports player, maybe one from the Boston area, maybe one that you look to growing up that's not from Boston.
Definitely from the Boston, I'd have to go with Tom Brady, you know, the typical Boston sports kid. He's just been such an inspiration growing up on and off the field, just the things that he's been doing. And I've also been a huge Kevin Garnett fan for his intensity on the floor.
How about favorite food or your favorite dinner meal that you know, if you could have any one thing, what would it be?
Favorite meal? I have to go with chicken marsala. I think that was my last meal before I came out here. Made by my mom too. She makes the best, so
Shout out to mom there. How about some things that we'd find, you know, that you're listening to music wise or maybe favorite bands or favorite songs?
I listen to a lot of music. Hip-hop and rap, you know, Drake, The Normal. And I also like the throwbacks, like CCR, Creedence Clearwater, you know.
How about favorite place to vacation, or travel to with family or friends?
Favorite place to travel, I'd probably say maybe Maine with my friends. My buddy has a house up there. We go up there once every summer, you know, just relax and have a good time.
Cool. And how about the last one? This is not supposed to not be the hardest one, but how about your favorite? You're an economics guy. You mentioned that, political science. Your favorite class at Union College that you've even either taken or, you know, that you're just starting here your senior year?
Favorite class? Favorite class, I have to go with macroeconomics that I took my sophomore year. It was a really interesting class, and I learned a lot. I think it definitely helped me in real life.
Well, that's Griffin Beal, one of your senior co-captains on the 2019 Union College football team. We will take one more break and be back for the second half. You're listening to Union versus Westfield State right here on the Dutchman Radio Network.
And our thanks to Griffin Beal for spending some time with us after practice. That was actually after Thursday's practice. He shout out to Griffin's mom there, who the chicken marsala, it sounds good. And being a Boston guy, of course, he brings up Tom Brady, City of Champions, which there's plenty of New England fans in this Capital District, so some, I'm sure, loving it, some not so not so much pro Boston, which is obviously the sports teams there have seen a string of success over the last 15 or so years in all four of the major sports. Getting ready for the second half, Union doing it all here in the first half. Dutchman lead at 35-0. We'll take one more short break, and then we'll be back here on Union College football and Union College athletics.
New country lessons of late from the broad partner of Union College athletics. And invite you to experience breathtaking Lexus performance by coming in for a test ride today. Thank you. let's welcome back to the field your Union College Huntsmen.
Back here at Bailey Field, getting ready for the second half. Union leads it 35-0. And you have to wonder, as we saw some of the backups sprinkle in, if Coach Behrman will try to get most of his guys in here in this season opener. And also, this being a non-conference game, non-league game, I wonder how much they'll kind of keep in their back pocket here, leading 35-0. The offense picked up right where it left off last season, averaging 31 points per game. Again, high expectations for this team. Union's won 7 games in back-to-back seasons for head coach Jeff Behrman, who is 17-13 all-time here, beginning his fourth season. Union went 3-1 at Frank Bailey Field last season, only 4 home games. This year there's 6 home games at Bailey Field. Of course, last year, ending the season with that big win over RPI. The Engineers still represented the Liberty League in the NCAA tournament, but Union getting the Dutchman shoes back after a 34-10 victory to end last season. And they picked up right where they left off. They put 35 up here on Westfield State in the first half. Union fans, Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady is open for lunch and dinner before or after Union games. It's the place to watch college football and hockey with friends and family. That's Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College Athletics. The Union's going to get the ball here. They remember they won the coin toss and deferred to the second half, so Union will get the football leading 35-0. It will actually be the first kick for Westfield State, as they didn't kick at all in that first half, and they received to start the game. So junior Cam Gallagher from Uxbridge, Massachusetts, tees it up. Union has its returner standing back at the 10-yard line. I think this is Raybacks. Getting to the near sideline, pushed out of bounds, out over the 35. Good return. Raybacks is just a freshman from Westport, Connecticut. Really made the only blunder, I guess, in that first half, and that's kind of harsh, although he called a fair catch and then had it bounce off of him, and Westfield State recovered. The defense bailed him out. He made a nice return there, taking it from the 10 all the way out to the 36. Coaching staff must have some trust in Raybacks, just a freshman. Made a nice return there, 26 yards out to the 36, and that's where Union's offense will take over. First down and 10 for the Dutch. And quarterback John Germanario. Germanario, handoff. Ferreira pushed out of bounds. Close to a first down, pickup of 9 to the 45. So I.K. Irabor went over 100 yards. That's 4 straight games dating back to last year, where he finished off last season with 3 straight 100-yard games. So if he doesn't take another snap, he'll finish with 11 carries for 108 yards. Second down and one from the 45. German Aereo takes the snap. Pass complete on the far side to Faya. Little quick hitter. And Faya has the first down. He's pushed out of bounds at the 48. So Union will move the chains here to start the second half. Opening minute of this third quarter. German Aereo hands up the middle. That's Ferreira. Expect to see a good dose of Ferreira and Griff Wallner in this second half. Ferreira get a yard up to midfield. Three receivers here to the near side for German Aereo. Shotgun snap, handoff to Ferreira, going up the middle, following that big offensive line, which has got some new faces out there, including sophomore Joe Petroski. Also freshman Stan Koss, Steven Cervani, Kevin Dewing, and Ryan Rockenbach. So backups, offensive linemen working in, although three freshmen and a sophomore. And I missed that. 15-yard penalty being assessed against Westfield State is going to move Union all the way down to the Owls 31.
With the penalty.
So Union moving here, first drive of the second half. If you missed the first half, lots of Union offense. In fact, the first three drives were all touchdowns for the Dutchman. Faking the handoff, German Aereo rolls to the right. He's got his man, Herman, and Herman goes all the way down to the 15. First down, Union. Mark it at the 14. Pickup of 17. The Union offense is just on a roll here as the fans start to trickle back in from the halftime break. Union looking to put up a score here before everyone's back in their seats. German Aereo in the pistol. Ferreira behind him. Ferreira's got the handoff, running right, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Joe Ferreira. Big hole on the right side. Ryan Rockenbach and Joe Petroski clearing things out. And Union leads it 41-0. Kick up and it is good.
The point is good. With 12:23 remaining in the third quarter, your score, Union 42, Westfield State 0.
That was Will Halpin who actually went out and kicked it, the extra point. Union leads 42-0 with 12:23 to go in the third quarter. Well, they start the second half like they started the first half. Union fans, Brown Coach is the official charter company and a proud supporter of Union College Athletics and Union College Football. Call Brown Coach or Brown Travel for all of your charter and travel needs. That's Brown Coach, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College Athletics. 42-0, Union. Ferreira's second touchdown of the afternoon and second career touchdown. That's the only thing Erebor missed out on. He went over 100 yards in that first half but didn't find the end zone. One of the few players who didn't find the end zone in that first half is William Bellamy, threw four touchdown passes in the first half. Here's Garvey trying to make his way up the far sideline out over the 35, and that's where Westfield State will start its offense here in the second half with 12:18 to go in this third quarter.
Ball plays at the 37 yard line, first and 10 from the 37.
Cassidy out there at quarterback for the Owls. Handoff going up the middle, being turned and tossed around.
Tackle on the play. Number 7, Will Sermon.
It was Shane Clark.
At the 39-yard line, number 2.
On the little run up the middle for 2 yards for the Owls. It'll bring up 2nd and 8. Snap. They give it to Clark again. This time he's met in the backfield.
Shane Clark on the play.
Tackle coming in. Sophomore linebacker Michael Polanski. Third down and 11 now for Westfield State. Cassidy rolls to his left, has a little bit of time, puts it up, almost intercepted. Mark Zazzaro was looking for his 2nd interception of the game. Zazzaro and DJ Martin were colliding as they both went try to intercept that pass, which was intended for Evan Garvey, and that'll bring up 4th down. Cody Cleveland back into the game to punt for Westfield State. Had 5 punts in that first half. Getting quite a workout. Union return men standing at the 25. Cleveland has a nice hang time as that one, again, hangs up there. No fair catch called for. I think there was a little bit of confusion there as the Westfield State defender just kind of pulled up. And that was
Julian
Banderjai, freshman from Madison, Connecticut, who brings it out to the 37. But that's where Union will take over. 1st down and 10. Union fans, be sure to stop by Center Street Pub, located at 308 Union Street in Schenectady, featuring TVs to watch all of your favorite teams, great food, and live entertainment. Center Street is a proud partner of Union College Athletics and Union College Football. German Aereo in the shotgun fakes the handoff. Pass complete. On the near side, it's Josh Shresha, a sophomore from Mendon, Massachusetts, and he loses a yard back to the 36. Tried to get it out in space to a playmaker like Shresha, who had 12 catches last season, averaged 10 yards a catch. Again, Union does not have an incompletion in this game. It's kind of hard to believe, but German Aereo is 7 for 7, and Bellamy was 11 for 11 in the first half. Handoff up the middle. Griff Wallner puts his head down and pushes a defender out to the 44-yard line. Short of the 1st down, but it'll be 3rd and 3 for the Dutchman. Good-looking run for Griff Wallner. Again, Union sprinkling in some other players in the offensive line here, and they're still getting a good push against this defensive line, which is doesn't have much experience for Westfield State, but Coach Kowalski said he thought they'd be good in time. They're just getting a quick test here. He even said we might take some lumps. That was a nice play out on the far side. Good tackle by Naquez Saunders.
Tackled on the play, number 31, Nikwa Sanders.
So that'll bring up fourth down. A caught pass was caught by Josh Shresha. Let's see if Union keeps the offense on the field. They bring the punter on.
That play will bring up fourth down.
And Union is going to bring on the punter. First time in this game that the Dutchman will punt. As the ball is spotted at the 44, it's fourth and three. So Will Halpin, the senior from nearby Latham, Shaker High grad, will come out for his first punt of the 2019 season. Standing back to receive is Cam Gallagher. Punt goes off the side of Halpin's foot, but it gets a couple of bounces inside the 25, and it'll be downed at about the 24-yard line. And that's where Westfield State will take over with 8:50 to go in this third quarter. It's Union 42, Westfield State nothing.
Ball placed at the 24-yard line.
Union wasn't really set on defense. Pass complete to Gallagher from Cassidy. Short gain working the far side of the field. Union's defense, some of the players were looking back at defensive coordinator Rick Flanders. I don't think they were quite set yet. Cassidy snapped it, picked up 5 yards on the pass to Gallagher. Little pitch and catch. Faking the handoff, Cassidy's got a hole up the middle, and he's out over the 40, first down Westfield State. One of the biggest plays offensively for the Owls in this game as Cassidy faked the handoff, kept it himself, and went scampering up to the 43 for a first down.
Again, a 14 on the play, first and 10 from the 43.
Cassidy pulls it down, run into the near side, spinning, and he goes into Union territory close to another first down. Well, I'll tell you, Westfield State came in. They were a ball control running type of team, and they got out of that quickly because Union scored on its first three drives. But Cassidy shown the ability to run. He ran for 450 yards last season. Threw for only 906 yards. So they feel more comfortable running the football. They just haven't been able to, and now they're down 42-0. They've kind of had to open it up a little bit more, although they had 3 and 4 receiver sets here. Handoff for Belcedo, and he is taken down in the backfield. Nice play.
Christopher Belcedo on the play.
No room to run. Coming up and making the stop was Michael Polanski. Loss of one or two back to midfield, and it'll be third and call it three. Union defense trying to get off the field here. Third and short. Cassidy takes the snap, has time, throws, complete. First down, that's Garvey. And Garvey goes inside the 45 as he kind of just sat down in that route and made the catch. Pickup of about 6 or 7. They needed 3. And so it keeps the Westfield State drive alive with 6:10 to go in this third quarter. Man in motion, that's Gallagher. Cassidy fakes the handoff, keeps it himself. Big hole up the middle, and he's got a first down before he's tackled by Matt Sermonario. Sophomore from Fairfield, Connecticut, came up to make the hit.
First down for the Owls. First and
First down, Westfield State. Ball at the 33. Cassidy hands off to Everett Welcome. Everett Welcome goes inside the 30. He is a big back, 6 foot, 255. Jermaine Everett Welcome. If he gets ahead of steam, he's going to be hard to bring down. That's what he did there as he picked up six. Five minutes to go in this third quarter. Union leading 42 to nothing. But Westfield State on the march. Snap, Cassidy fakes the handoff, throws it, and it's a little short for his receiver. Looking for Adam Cahill, his senior tight end. Ball was just a little bit underthrown from Cassidy to Cahill.
Ball plays at the 27-yard line, third down from the 27.
Third down and four. Cassidy being pressured, gets rid of it. Pass caught, but going nowhere is Garvey as he's taken down by Sermonario. Garvey lost a couple of yards. I think Westfield State going to keep the offense on the field. That makes sense here. Fourth and six from the Union 30. Cassidy takes the snap, rolls right, being pressured, gets hit. Flag comes, pass caught. And it's going to be short of the first down, Cahill, but I believe there's going to be a roughing the passer here as Cassidy took a nice shot after he got rid of the football. So the drive will stay alive after the pass was caught, but not enough for the first down, but a roughing the passer will move the ball inside the 15.
With the penalty, the ball will be placed at the 11-yard line. First and 10 from the 11.
Ball moved to the Union 11. First down and 10 for the Owls. Trying to crack the scoreboard here. Under 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. Handoff. Everett Welcome. He gets moving. And then a nice tackle up high from Michael Polanski. We've called his name a number of times. Linebacker from Wallingford, Connecticut, sophomore. Polanski playing in the middle.
Second down from the nine.
Everett Welcome picked up two. Westfield State not really in a hurry here. Although I think they'd like to get on the scoreboard. And this is an offense that, under head coach Pete Kowalski, averaged 23 points per game last season. Slant pass is knocked down. There was a lot of traffic over there. He was looking for Garvey.
Pass intended for number one, Evan Garvey. Third down.
Third down and nine. Westfield can get a first down if they get to about the 1 yard line. Slant complete to Garvey. Helmet flies off as Garvey gets taken down. Not his helmet, but Union player lost his helmet. It's going to be short of the first down. A losing his helmet was Union's number two, Ian Butler. So he has to come off for a play. So it'll be fourth down. Westfield can get a first down. Union trying to keep this shutout intact. Fourth and call it two from the four. Everett, welcome. Head of steam, but he is steamrolled. Big stop for the Dutchman defense. Thomas Cavallo, freshman from Hopewell Junction, and Jamar Edwards. Stuff the middle, and Union will take over on downs. So Union will take over first and 10 just outside of its own goal line. Germanario hands off. I believe that's Ferreira. And he gets out to about the 10-yard line. Gives Union a little bit more space to work. 5-yard pickup for the Dutchman. Big hole up the middle for Ferreira. Ball came out late, but he is down as the referee comes in pointing at the turf. It's about the third or fourth time Westfield State has thought they recovered a fumble, and the referees have said the player was down. Big hole for Ferreira and a first down for the Dutchman. As we tick down here in this third quarter, it's been all Union. Dutchman led 35-0 at halftime. They tacked on a touchdown to start this second half from Ferreira, and they lead 42-0. Here's Ferreira again and gets that second level of defense. Elijah Ellis, who's been all over around the ball for the Owls, comes up to make the stop, but Ferreira picks up 5 or 6. At the 27-yard line, make it a 26-yard line. Germanario in the pistol. Handoff for Ferreira, and Ferreira's got a first down out over the 30. So Union's been able to, and they haven't been going up top, and in the first half when it was William Bellamy connecting deep with Andre Ross Jr., there's been a lot of room to run for Ferreira, Griff Wallner, and I.K. Irabor, as Union is just piling up the yards here. And that'll be the end of this third quarter. At the end of the third quarter, your score, Union 42, Westfield State 0, the third quarter of today's game is coming up. Thank you. Union has 467 yards of offense. .226 yards on the ground, 241 yards passing. Still no incompletions. That's incredible. Germanario, 8 of 8. Bellamy, 11 of 11. As Union leads it 42-0 after three quarters. Union fans, Trustco Bank is proud to be a leading community sponsor of Union College Athletics and Union College Football, offering residential mortgages, hometown checking, and friendly personal service. Trustco Bank has been serving our community since 1902. That's Trustco Bank, a proud supporter of Union College and Union College Football. We switch sides. Union has it first and 10 at its own 31 as we start this fourth quarter. Faking the handoff to Ferrara and a pass complete. To Connor Finn. Finn gets out to the 37. As German Aereo, still no incompletions between German Aereo and Bellamy. I would have to imagine that that has not happened in either a long time or ever in Union College history, that there's been no incomplete passes. It's still 14 minutes and 30 seconds to go in this game, so it could happen very well. Ball's out. And Westfield State has it. So a turnover for Union. As it was a handoff, I think Wallner lost the football. And Westfield State's going to take over at the Union 38-yard line. So Union's had two turnovers in this game. And if your Union head coach, Jeff Behrman, obviously, your team played has played very well. But he, I'm sure, and the rest of the coaching staff are going to pick out things that the team didn't do well and try to focus on those, although I'm sure they'll focus on some of the positives as well, and there's been plenty. Cassidy going up top. He's got a man open, and he overshot him. Miscommunication in the Union secondary because running down the field unchecked was Ethan Hallett, the backup tight end, junior. Nobody was guarding him, and the pass was just a little too far. That would have been likely a touchdown, although Hallett did fall down, so he may not have made it in, but he had nobody in front of him in the goal line. Second down and 10. Quick pass out here to Gallagher. Gallagher's got some room, and he'll step out of bounds after a first down to the 25. Pickup of 13, and it'll be a first down and 10 for the Owls, who are still looking to try to crack that scoreboard. They got close last possession, but Union held them out just inside the 5. Handoff for Belcito. Belcito running to the right, takes a hit, keeps on ticking, and gets inside the 20. Pickup of 5. There hasn't been much room to run for Westfield State. Again, this is a ball control run style offense, according to head coach Pete Kowalski. They were top 10 in the country in time of possession last year, and they may have actually had the ball for longer than Union in this game. However, not, I think, what they're looking for moving forward. I think they want to control the clock. Caught on the far side by Gallagher, who got up near the first down line and kind of turned around and got tackled facing the opposite goal.
Number 7.
So I think he's going to be 1 yard short. I think he was trying to back up and make a move around and turn back the other way. And he got tackled with his back facing the end zone. So it's 3rd and 1. And Cassidy will set up here. 12:45 to go. Union leading 42-0. But Westfield State on the march. Belcito, he's got the first down, and he's inside the 15 to the 13. Senior from Webster, Massachusetts.
Tackle on the play. Number 42. Emilio Camus. A gain of 4 on the play. Results in a first down for the Owls. First and 10.
Pass complete to Gallagher. And Gallagher will step out at about the 9.
Gallagher on the play.
Pickup of 4.
Second down.
Westfield,
bounds, number 21.
Not really huddling, getting right to the line here. 12 minutes to go. Cassidy has three receivers. This is Belcito running left. He's got a couple of blockers. Now he's being
Christopher Belcito
taken down.
Tackled on the play. Number 53.
Cam Kane. Junior from Dorchester, Mass.
Third down.
Third down and short here for Westfield State. Run up the middle, pushed back, and not going to get the first down. It'll be fourth down. That was actually Cavallo on the last stop for the Dutchman.
Fourth down.
This is about the whole team out there making the stop. Fourth down and 2 or 3, and Union's sideline trying to get up here to have its defense stand up again against this Westfield State offense. 10:50 to go. Union up 42-0, but trying to hold on to that shutout. Faking the handoff. Cassidy's going to roll. He's going to look to do it himself, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. Jake Cassidy, the senior from Salem, Mass.
Jake Cassidy on the play.
A 5-yard scamper, and Westfield State is on the scoreboard. Extra point up and good from Corey Pooler.
Ethan Hallett is good.
Pooler adds the extra point. It's 42-7 Union with 10:37 remaining in this game. Union fans, Wolf's Beer Garden in Schenectady is offering the best German local and craft brews. Join Wolf's for lunch, dinner, and weekend brunch. Plus, every Wednesday is Union Night at Wolf's, your official tailgating and away game watch party for Union football, plus men's and women's hockey. That's Wolf's Beer Garden, located in Schenectady. And, of course, the Dutchman will be on the road next week at Anna Maria in Paxton, Massachusetts. 1 o'clock kick at Anna Maria. You can head on down to Wolf's and catch that game. As the Dutchman will look to knock off Anna Maria and improve to 2-0. Kick taken by Rebax on the far side.
Cam Gallagher on the kickoff.
Spins out of a tackle and now hit down hard. Before he could reach the 30. And that's where Union's offense will take over.
A 25-yard return.
So for Union early season schedule, 2 weeks from today, be back here against Springfield, which is always a strong opponent. So the first three games, Westfield State, Anna Maria, and Springfield, three Massachusetts foes, before they hop into Liberty League play to take on Hobart and Rochester. Buff State has entered the Liberty League. short run on that first play for the Dutchman. Second run in a row for T.J. Gale, the sophomore from New Windsor, New York. Another short run. That went out to the 32-yard line. Just got a note from key statistician guru Eric Hornick that Bellamy and German Aereo have completed at least the first 20 passes, which ties the NCAA Division III record for consecutive completions by multiple QBs in one game, which was set by, or the record was set by Baldwin Wallace in 1994. So thanks to that statistic, Eric Hornick always good for statistics like that, and Union hasn't had an incompletion. German Aereo 9-for-9 as they pick up another first down, and Bellamy was 11-for-11 in that first half. So Union completing its first 20 passes in this game still without an incompletion. Now 21 after that last completion. This a run right up the middle. Big hole.
Number 38.
For T.J. Gale again. Gale gets out near midfield at the 48, pickup of 9. 8:15 to go here, Union leading this one 42-7. Gale again takes the handoff for German Aereo. I think he's going to get the first down before being pushed back by a host of Westfield State defenders. He does have the first down out to the 49.
That play results in a first down for the Dutchman. Game of one on the play. First and 10 from the 49.
German Aereo looking to the sideline. 7:25 to go in this game. Handoff for Gale again. Gets through the first line of defense before he's turned back by Elijah Ellis. Pickup of 3. Union goes into Westfield State territory. Ball at the 48. Well, the Dutchmen played pretty sound football. They did just give up a touchdown here. And actually, if you're looking at the score by half, it's 7-7 in the second half. But Union played a lights-out first half, led 35-0 at halftime, if you're just joining us. And it's pretty much all Dutchmen early, scoring on their first three drives. Gale again, falling ahead to the 45. Union has put up some impressive statistics. I know when I talked to head coach Jeff Behrman, he wasn't interested in talking about statistics, but Union is about to go over 250 yards rushing and already has over 250 yards receiving. So over 500 yards of offense for the Dutchman here in the season opener. Third down and 4 from the Westfield 45. German Aereo takes the snap. The throw caught for a first down.
Number 6, Ryan Sullivan.
Caught by senior Ryan Sullivan from Mayo Pack, New York. And so the completion streak continues as German Aereo completes another one to the Westfield 40. Here's Gale again.
DJ Gale on the play.
Gale gets 4 yards to the Westfield 36.
Robbie Nelson, number 36, Dan O'Leary. Gain of 4 on the play. Second and 6 from the 36.
Second down, 6. 4 minutes, 40 seconds to go. German Ariel takes the snap, hands to Gale. Gale running left of center, of the center, I should say. And he gets ahead for 4 yards. It'll be third and short for the Dutchman. Germanario in the pistol. Handoff up the middle. First down inside the 30. Another new running back out there for the Dutchman. That's number 39, Kyle Goldman, junior from Los Angeles, California. His first carry is good for a first down. Goes inside the 30 to the 29, and I think head coach Jeff Behrman is content with running this thing out. Remember, he ran out the clock in the first half when Union was kind of driving and up 35-0. They tacked on one more touchdown to start the second half. Goldman again. This time he's swallowed up by the Westfield defense. Lost a yard back to the 30. But I think Union passes this first test with flying colors as they lead it 42-7 with under 3 minutes to go. Again, I would imagine not having an incompletion certainly ties an NCAA record, as the stats say both quarterbacks 11 for 11, which would be a perfect 22 for 22. Run up the middle with Goldman to the 25, pick up a 5. It'll be 3rd and 6. A Westfield, I think, player had to go off for losing a helmet. They wind that clock again. 2:05 to go. I think some of the Union fans want to see the team continue its march down the field towards the end zone, but I think head coach Jeff Behrman is content with running a few more plays and running this clock out, going home 1-0. Goldman again. Stopped in the backfield. Nice play. Cameron Danahy came up and made the hit for Westfield, a freshman. Flag on the play. 1:32 to go in this game. Unsportsmanlike conduct was the call on Westfield State, so that will move the ball all the way down inside the 15, and Union takes a timeout. It's the play Union fans, visit Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady. Open for lunch and dinner before or after Union games. It's the place to watch college football and hockey with friends and family. Katie O'Byrne's Irish Pub in downtown Schenectady. Just down the road, RPI knocked off Allegheny 52-14. RPI also piled up 502 yards of offense, knocking off the Gators of Allegheny. That game started at noon. So RPI, a 52-14 winner. They were the preseason pick to win the Liberty League. They did lose a lot of players to graduation. They do have their quarterback back. Speaking of quarterback, a new quarterback hands off to Goldman, who is surging towards the end zone. Almost got a first down. And the new quarterback is number 12, Jason Feldman, a sophomore from Staten Island, New York. So I can't imagine he's going to throw it. But so it looks like Union's going to finish this game perfect 22 for 22 passing. Unless, I mean, I've been wrong before. Under a minute to play. Union's going to take a knee here. So that will do it. As Feldman takes a knee. One more of those, I think, will do it. I don't know if they'll have to snap it again. Well, the play clock got reset and now is at 40, so I don't think they will have to snap it again. I thought they were going to have to, but that will be it. Quite a way to start the season for Union head coach Jeff Behrman and the Dutchmen as they improve to 1-0 and knock off Westfield State 42-7 in a game. I guess it's hard to say it was not as close as the score showed, even though they won by 35. Union raced out to a 35-0 halftime lead and probably could have dropped 50 or 60 today in what was a most impressive performance from the Dutchman, who will travel to Anna Maria next Saturday before being back home 2 weeks from today when they take on the Pride of Springfield. So we'll quickly look at some end-of-game statistics, and then we'll head out of here again. All Union College in this one. Dutchman 42, Owls 7. And still the statistic that I'm wondering about is the Union quarterbacks going 22 for 22 passing. Will Bellamy, 11 of 11 in that first half, 4 touchdowns, 192 yards. John Germanario came in, went 11 of 11 himself for 67 yards. Rushing the football, I.K. Irabor, who did not play in the second half, had 11 carries for 108 yards. Joseph Ferreira had 2 touchdowns, 14 carries for 81 yards. And receiving-wise, Andre Ross Jr., 4 catches for 125 yards and 3 touchdowns. Griffin Beal, 4 catches for 54 yards and a touchdown, 3 catches for Robbie Herman. Defensively, Union was led by Cavallo and had 6 tackles. Mays, DiCaterino, and Polanski had 5 tackles. Jamar Edwards played a nice game in his first game as a Union Dutchman. Polanski had two tackles for loss. DiCaterino and Jamar Edwards had a tackle for loss. And really, Union did pretty much all that it wanted to do, especially in that first half. For Westfield State, Jake Cassidy, 11 of 20 for 57 yards and one interception. Receiving the ball, Cam Gallagher had five catches for 30 yards. Rushing the ball, Jake Cassidy had the lone touchdown on the ground, nine carries, 33 yards of net yards. And Chris Bellacido had eight carries for 30 yards. Jermaine Everett Welcome, eight carries for 5 yards. Team statistics, Union, as you can imagine, dominated. First downs 30-10. Outrushed Westfield State 274-69. Outpassed the Owls 259-57. Total yards, Union 533, Westfield State 126. So that will do it here. Union improves to 1-0, and they start the 2019 season with a victory and a resounding one of that. Dutchman will be on the road at Anna Maria next Saturday, back home in 2 weeks here at Frank Bailey Field when they take on Springfield. Some thank yous before we sign off. Of course, thank you to Steve Sheridan, Ross Ledoux, the Union College Sports Information staff. Thank you to Union football head coach Jeff Behrman for joining us in the pregame. Union athletic director Jim McLaughlin and his staff. Thanks to Griffin Beal for joining us at halftime. And thanks as well to Westfield State University SID David Caspol for setting us up with Westfield State's head coach in the week leading up to the game. Thank you to the Fighting Dutchman Gridiron Club, and thanks to you for listening and tuning us in here at unionathletics.com. We'll see you in 2 weeks when the Dutchmen are back home against Springfield. Union is 1-0 after a 42-7 victory over Westfield State. So long, good afternoon.